In this video, we show how to measure the speed of a bicycle by using slow motion video from an iPhone. We start with a quick reminder of constant velocity kinematics. When the velocity of an object is constant, we can write distance equals rate times time, or delta x equals v delta t. Note that if we're keeping track of direction in this equation, delta x should be called the displacement. That's how far something has moved in addition to a plus or minus sign to indicate direction. And v should be called velocity. That's the speed with the plus or minus sign indicating direction. But in this video, we're just going to work in magnitudes here. And so I can say that my delta x is really a distance. It's just how far I went. And my v is really a speed. It's just how fast I was going without using the plus or minus sign for direction. So provided we have the distance delta x and the time delta t, we can solve for the speed here. And the units we'll be using are meters for the distance, seconds for the time, so meters per second. And we'll do a conversion to miles per hour at the very end. So to find delta x, we marked two points on a trail with flagging tape and a line of chalk. My finishing line is right there. My starting line is right there. And we measured the separation distance out with the measuring tape at 5 meters plus or minus a few centimeters. So that's our delta x. So I can be really conservative and say there's uncertainty in the tenths place. So we're going to write this to two significant digits as 5.0 meters. But how are we going to measure the time delta t to cross from the starting point to the finishing point? We decided to use slow motion video for this because the high frame rate of slow motion video gives us a more precise measure of the time compared to ordinary speed video. But in order to figure out the time, we have to count frames and use the frame rate of the slow motion feature on our iPhone. To get to the frame rate on your phone, go to Settings, then Camera, then Record Slow-Mo. On my phone, slow motion is recorded at 240 frames per second. And it's useful to flip that conversion factor around and say there's 1 second for every 240 frames. I can then simplify the 1 over 240, and I find out there's about 0.004 seconds per frame. So conservatively, I'm going to say when I'm counting frames in this slow motion video, I might miss by up to 2 frames. That would give me a little less than 1/100 of a second uncertainty. And again, I'm just being conservative with the precision here. So I'm going to say my uncertainty in the time is 1/100 of a second. So how do we go about converting the total number of frames that we count into a time? Well, suppose the total number of frames is called n. Then what I do is take my n frames and I multiply by the conversion factor, 1 second for every 240 frames. The units of frames are going to cancel out and leave me with units of seconds. All right, next we open QuickTime Player and I can view my bike ride in slow motion. But I want to count the frames on this from when my front wheel touches the starting line to when it touches the finishing line. So to get frame count, I go down to my timer in the lower left-hand corner. Just left-click on that and switch it to frame number. Now I can drag the video back and forth, and you'll see that it's counting what number frame it was. So I'm going to go ahead and put my front tire on the starting line. And again, there's a little bit of wiggle room here. People could disagree on exactly which frame it is, but we're taking that into account with our uncertainty. I'm going to say my tire crossed that line at 111 frames. And then we fast forward to the finishing line. And I'm going to say my tire crossed that finishing line at 243 frames. So we have a number of frames from start to finish of 243 for the finish, 111 for the start. And that gives me a total of 132 frames to cover 5 meters. I take my 132 frames. And I multiply by my conversion factor, 1 second for every 240 frames. Frames cancel out of this. And then I use a calculator to get 132 over 240. That comes out to 0.55 seconds. Now I already decided that I had about a 0.01 second uncertainty. So this is correctly rounded and I have two significant digits. Finally, we can get my speed. And remember that our delta x was 5.0 meters. That's two significant digits. Our delta t is 0.55 seconds, also two significant digits. So when we get our speed out of this, we'll round it to two significant digits. And that comes out to 9.1 meters per second. Finally, I'd like to look at my speed in miles per hour since that's the reference I'm used to. And I use the conversion 1 meter per second is 2.24 miles per hour. So I take my 9.1 meters per second and I multiply by this conversion factor in the correct order, that's 2.24 miles per hour. For every 1 meter per second, the meters per second cancel out and give me miles per hour. And this gives me about 20.4 miles per hour. But I really should be rounding to two significant digits, so I'm going to call it 20 miles per hour. So that's it on measuring the speed of an object with an iPhone. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.